And going through your rebuttal letter yesterday that was sent to us, very interesting explanations for all these charges. One of the most striking is it seems like there was one family group or the booster club group that has spearheaded this smear campaign against you.
Yes, that is true. And they are friends, and we've worked together for 2 or 3 years, and so they've spearheaded this. And a lot of it is about solos. A lot of it is about who is in charge of the program and those types of things. And so it boils back to that.
A lot of the arguments are about so-and-so's kid didn't get a solo, and yeah, that's what they're upset about, and that's what this is rooted in. Is it really that competitive that parents would be willing to ruin someone's career over a solo?
At our high school, we have the highest number of kids that make all West Honor Choir, highest number of kids that make all state from any high school in the state, highest number of kids that make all National Honor Choir. It's a very competitive atmosphere, and it's very competitive because the kids want to have the solos, and you're competing now, and so you want your best soloist to be there, and parents want their kids to be the best soloist, and so that becomes part of that reason. And then it can lead to you look for other things to complain about after that.
And how often would parents come forward with these complaints, just to you personally?
Generally at the end of the year, you know, when they look back on the year and they see, well, my kid only got one solo while someone else got 4 or 5, and that would be it. So
you've taught at other schools, other districts, other states. Have you had this issue? I know it.
No, not at all. I've not taught in college, taught for 20 years, 3 different schools, and this is the first time I've ever had this issue.
And no other complaints had been brought to your attention from those administrations?
No.